going to do dimensional analysis calculations for a couple of problems. Here we have a provider who orders fosphenytin, and it's ordered at 11 milligrams per kilogram IV once daily. The patient weighs 63 pounds, so automatically we know that we're going to have to convert kilograms and pounds. And it asks how many milligrams will the nurse prepare. So we already know that our unit of measure will be in milligrams. So milligrams, we're going to write an equal sign, draw a line. So now we're going to identify this as our unit of measure in milligrams. Draw a line so that we know visually that we need a numerator and denominator, and instantly we can add milligrams because our the first fraction and the unit that's identified in the first fraction has to be what we are looking for our unit of measure. So that's automatically, we know it's milligram. So what do we have that we know about in terms of milligram? Well, we have a physician's order or provider's order of 11 milligrams per kilogram. So we're going to put 11 here, milligrams to 1 kilogram. But our patient is weighed in pounds. So I'm going to make my multiplication sign, have my second numerator and denominator, and I know that in the numerator it has to be kilograms. We climb the hill, our unit down here is kilogram, we climb the hill and we put kilogram here. And what do we know about kilograms and pounds? Well, we know that there are 2.2 pounds in each kilogram. So we'll write 1 kilogram to 2.2 pounds. Okay, this is a given quantity here, but this is a conversion factor. So 1 kilogram is 2.2 pounds. We'll make our X. We'll have an additional numerator and denominator. We know that pounds will go into the numerator because we climb that hill, so pounds will go up here. What do we have that's pounds? Well, we have a given quantity that's 63 pounds. So 63 pounds, and we can use our placeholder. Are we ready to calculate? Well, how do we know we're ready? We know because we can cross out kilogram, kilogram, pound, pound, and all we have left is our unit of measure, which is milligram. So yes, we are ready to calculate. We're going to make our equal sign, and we're going to multiply the numerators together. So 11 times 63 is 693. And we'll multiply our denominators together, 1 times 2.2 times 1, which will be just 2.2, right? And that's going to equal, because we divide the numerator by the denominator, and that will be 315. So 315 what? 315 milligrams. Here we have Epoetin, and the provider has ordered Epoetin, which is Procrit, which is the trade name. Epoetin is the generic name. And the provider has ordered 110 units per kilogram. Subcut, which is subcutaneous, 3 times a week, Monday, Wednesday, Saturday. The pharmacy supplies Epoetin in a vial that contains 10,000 units in a milliliter. Patient weighs 50 kilograms. How many milliliters will the nurse draw up into the syringe? Round to the nearest tenth. So we know that our unit of measure that we're going to, what we are working on, is going to be milliliters. So milliliters, we draw our equal sign. We have then a line that we place, so we have a numerator and denominator. And what do we have that we know about milliliters? Because we're going to put our milliliters up here in the numerator spot. What do we know about milliliters in our given quantity information? Well, We know that each milliliter, because our pharmacy has sent up vials containing 10,000 units per milliliter, which means one milliliter has 10,000 units. So one milliliter is 10,000 units. Okay, we're going to make our multiplication sign, draw a line. We need a numerator and denominator. We know instantly that units will be in the numerator. So we can write that in. And what do we have that has units? Well, we can look and see that our provider has ordered 110 units per kilogram. So we can put 110 units is to 1 kilogram. Okay, draw an X and a line so we have a numerator and denominator. And we know that in the numerator, because we've got kilogram in the denominator here, we go up the hill and put kilogram up here. What do we have that's kilograms? Well, we know that the patient is weighing 50 kilograms. So let's write 50. And 1 is our placeholder. Are we ready to solve? Well, how do we know? Units cross out here. Kilograms cross out here. The only thing left is milliliters, and that's our unit of measure. So we can solve by multiplying the numerators together, and we get 5,500. Multiply the denominators together, and it's 10,000 by 1 by 1, which is 10,000. And calculate that out, and we get 0.55. And we're going to round to the nearest tenth, which comes out to be 0.6. 0.6 what? 0.6 milliliters, because that is what we're looking for. Yeah.